It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this scenario, your company wants to track whether someone is present in a meeting room reserved for a scheduled meeting. There are 1,000 meeting rooms across 5 offices on 3 continents. Each room is equipped with a motion sensor that reports its status every second. You want to support the data upload and collection needs of this sensor network. The receiving infrastructure needs to account for the possibility that the devices may have inconsistent connectivity. Which solution should you design? So, in this scenario, your company is globally spread. Across 3 continents, there are 5 offices, and among them, there are 1,000 meeting rooms. Each meeting room has a sensor that checks whether somebody is in the room and sends that information every second. A solution that we design has to hold up under those kind of load. We also need to consider that the devices would have an inconsistent connectivity. Therefore, they might be online now, but then they might not have a network connection for quite a while, which means that you could possibly have these events bunched up and suddenly all coming in one shot. Let's now look at what would be the best solution for these requirements. Option A suggests have each device create a persistent connection to a compute engine instance and write messages to a custom application. The first part of this option is saying that we have a persistent connection or a network that is inconsistent. Now, that's quite impossible or very difficult to achieve. Even if we did it, in some way we are trying to retain that connection, there'd be a lot more engineering required to make that happen. In general, this can be considered impractical. So to have a persistent connection or an inconsistent network would not be a good option. The second part of this option suggests that we use a compute engine instance. Now, we know that this is a lot of data coming in. It is possible that a single compute engine instance won't be able to accept that kind of load. Like I said, there's a chance that the network connectivity is not there for a while for a lot of these devices, and all the events from the time that there was no network connectivity could be accumulated and sent together. And that might happen multiple times. So, a single compute engine instance might not hold up under this kind of load. Moreover, when you have a single compute engine VM, it is going to be in one zone in one region. But our offices are spread all across the world. So there's going to be an increased latency for the data to arrive at one single point. And of course, when it is all coming in together, it's like all of the traffic, it might cause jams on the network. So all in all, this might not be a good option for what we want to get done. And we will eliminate option A. Option B suggests that we have devices poll for connectivity to Cloud SQL and insert the latest messages on a regular interval to a device-specific table. One thing about constant polling to figure out if something is up is that it increases the network overhead. It is going to be an unnecessary load on the server. So we are going to have a lot of noise in just checking whether the system is up as opposed to actually transmitting the data. So polling for devices under these conditions might not be a good thing to. Moreover, if we want to actually check if the database is up, it might even require making a database connection and doing a ping at the database protocol level. which means that we are also loading the database connections, and we might be overusing that as opposed to actually using it for real-world applications for required connections. So polling the Cloud SQL Server, I don't know if it's a good option. Also, Cloud SQL is a regional solution, which means that, again, it is going to be in one region, whereas our requirement has all these offices from across the world sending data. And that, again, increases the latency for this data to come to one place. Given those, we can eliminate option B. Option D suggests that we have devices create a persistent connection to an App Engine application frontend using cloud endpoints, which ingests messages and writes them to cloud data store. Now, again, the same problem of having a persistent connection over an inconsistent network. That is difficult to achieve. You could probably have WebSockets and have a persistent connection. You could probably have libraries that constantly poll internally. But like I said, all excess work. We would ideally prefer a simpler, more cleaner solution. Moreover, App Engine and Cloud Data Store by itself are again regional solutions. And just using them does not change a lot for us. So we've eliminated option D also. Option C suggests that we have devices poll for connectivity to Cloud PubSub and publish the latest messages on a regular interval to a shared topic for all devices. PubSub now is global by default. You can publish, consume, publish, subscribe from anywhere in the world, and it will automatically scale for you. So for our requirement, PubSub is a very good option. We also talked about the possibility that since there is inconsistent connectivity, you will have all these events bunched up or accumulated and coming in suddenly. So there might be sudden spikes in the data coming in, and our solution should be able to scale well. PubSub can do that. PubSub can absorb that kind of sudden growth and shield later part of the data processing pipeline from that kind of spikes. So that works well for us again. PubSub also guarantees delivery to the next stage in the data pipeline. Even if the connectivity from the PubSub to the data processing pipeline has some kind of issues, we can have PubSub guarantee delivery of those events at some point in time. So it is very reliable to capture and forward messages. So on these points, option C is looking really good for us. Now, this idea of these devices polling for connectivity to Cloud PubSub, that seems odd for me. And that doesn't sit very well with the rest of the solution. Again, if you're going to be constantly polling a service to find out if it is available, then it is going to increase the network overhead. These devices will have to be constantly checking before they send data whether it is up or not. So that part doesn't sound too good. What you do with PubSub typically is that you try to publish it, and if it succeeds, then you get back an ID. And you get a 200 OK. As a HTTP status code. And if you don't get that, we can then retry another time. So the polling part, even though it does not seem appropriate, the rest of the solution that we have for this seem to be the most correct among all these options. Therefore, I'm going to choose option C as the most correct one in the available options. And that would be our best answer. Now, it's time to subscribe to all the great content we've got lined up for you to learn Google Cloud and to help you with the certifications.